I'll read it from the PDF, though. Might make it just easier for us. Okay. So.
Tell me about it.
Do you want to read the startup lore?
Yes.
Okay. All right. I'm going to assume this hot gangsta rap is going to be a good background ambience. Let's just begin. The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule to attempt to wrest the golden Triforce from the sacred realm. His first incursion was thwarted by the sages.
Redo it.
The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule to attempt to wrest the golden Triforce from the sacred realm. His first incursion was thwarted by the sages, but in the titanic battle that ensued, the Triforce was shattered and its myriad shards scattered throughout the kingdom. Some fell into the hands of the wise leaders of Hyrule. Some came to the common folk. Many were gifted by Ganondorf to his followers for protection.
Sounds like Lord of the Rings with the rings, but go on.
Without the binding of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together.
Okay, can we get a an ABC take on Triforce?
Wait, what?
An ABC take.
What does that mean?
For that line. Three takes. All different.
Oh, okay. Without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together. Without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together. And without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together. Which one should we go for, Chief?
Let's go with the first one. I think that one's good.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together.
Tell me about it.
The world itself came fuck. All right, I'm starting over. Sorry, boss.
Start at the beginning.
Okay. The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf.
redo it. Fuck. Come on, we don't got all day, man. We need a good take. Let's go.
The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once
again. Okay, hang on.
Yep.
Can we get Ganondorf with a bit more, malevolence?
Yeah, gotcha. Sorry. The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came
there
once again.
There you go.
Thank you. Shit.
Redo.
The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule to attempt to wrest the Golden Triforce from the Sacred Realm. His first incursion was thwarted by the sages, but in the titanic battle that ensued, the Triforce was shattered. Fuck. Alright, you know what? Fuck the lore. Shit's all over the place. Let's see how to play the
game. Can we go British accent?
Okay, let's take five.
I told you guys, we should have got micro for this.
Can we get a Patrick Parr voice for the intro? The Dark Realm.
Dr. Patrick Parr. Fuck. All right, let's see. Overview. This will explain the game, okay?
But I have no interest in the game now. Or these characters that I know nothing about.
This guy named Ganondorf.
That's all I know, and apparently he's very sinister from some great voice acting, but that's all I've been told so far.
The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule to attempt to wrest the golden Triforce from the sacred realm. His first incursion was thwarted by the sages. But in the titanic battle that ensued, the Triforce was shattered, and its myriad shards scattered throughout the kingdom. Some fell into the hands of the wise leaders of Hyrule. Some came to the common folk. Many were gifted by Ganondorf to his followers for protection. Without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom.
I didn't ask for this!
Hold on, a small child's interrupting this whole thing.
Redo, I'm not convinced.
Fucking goddamn it.
Alright, one more from the top.
The darkness of the times. Fuck.
That's not the line.
Fuck.
Look, let's hold off on the improv. Uh-huh. Let's stick with the script.
Sorry, you're right. The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule to attempt to wrest the golden Triforce from the sacred realm. His first incursion was thwarted by the sages, but in the titanic battle that ensued, the Triforce was scattered and its myriad shards scattered throughout the kingdom. Some fell into the hands of the wise leaders of Hyrule. Some
I didn't ask for this!
Common folk. Many were gifted by Ganondorf to his followers for protection. Without the binding power of the Triforce to hold the kingdom of Hyrule together, the world itself became fragmented and disjointed. The shadows of many worlds extending throughout the
multiplicitous.
That's not even real, is it?
It is.
That's bullshit. Dimensions of time and space and blurring into each other. Mind-bending rifts in the fabric of reality. Across the land, strange devices began to appear, extruding into this dimension from the realm that governed the very physical laws of the world. Cog-like machines would materialize.
I didn't ask for this!
I'm sorry, but Mama said to knock you out, Krykak.
Cog-like
the
machines.
Dark realm.
The dark times have returned. And nowhere.
Yeah, you laughing ain't gonna pay my bills, so. Let's go. The dark times.
The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once
again. I didn't ask for this!
Why does a small boy keep walking in the room?
I'm sorry. I'm confused.
Oh, yeah, that's my nephew. He's really, he wants to get into voice acting, so he's trying to see other people doing it. Yeah, I know. I'm sorry. We're not going
to
bill you for the time that he's wasting.
Why do we bring your nephew to work day?
Yeah, that's the worst fucking day. The worst. Oh. The dark times have returned. The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf, came once again to Hyrule.
I didn't ask for this!
I'm done. I'm just reading the fucking game now. Alright.
The dark times.
Yeah, I don't know if this game's for me,
the
man.
The evil prince of darkness, Ganondorf.
Wanna play that Battlegrounds game?
No. Alright. The Legend of Zelda Clockwork Realm is a
Orange.
Clockwork Orange is a cooperative campaign-based game designed to be played over 4 sessions of approximately 1 to 2.5 hours each.
Fuck that.
Yeah, why are we doing this?
You won't want to be a Pokemon Master Trainer?
Fucking load up some chests or something, dude. I ain't got the dedication for like a
Tell
month's worth of this
it.
Game, are you kidding me? I'm already bored of it, we haven't even started playing.
But it's a fun game.
How do we play?
I didn't ask for this!
I don't know yet.
Oh hey, sorry for all the interruptions. Just wanted to let you know I can now hear colors after all the bar hacks. Choo-choo.
We're not gonna finish this, I promise.
Thank you, Terminal Kirby. Alright. If you don't want to play this, I have another game idea.
Oh shit,
it's
I'm sorry.
It's more closer to things we know, like Coup. It's closer to that. I don't know if we're gonna like it, but I saw Kryken playing it earlier, and it looked like it could be fun.
What are the rules?
I don't know yet. Hold on. This is how we do. Give me one moment. Pull it up here. It was not actually.
What the fuck is this?
What is what?
Cogveyor example.
Oh. Oh god, I don't know.
It's this fucking minesweeper that's happening here.
My immersion crying on me.
Listen, your immersion's dead. I'm sorry.
He rotates the room containing Cogbear anti-clockwise. What?
I bet this game could be fun if we committed, but I understand if you don't have the,
I didn't ask for
the
this.
Desire to do
so. I didn't realize it takes that long.
It's fair.
You could always play Betrayal of the House on the Hill. That's always a good time, and it's been a while.
That is, Betrayal of the House on the Hill is a game. That is true. But
when are we gonna play Borrow Trauma?
Borrow Trauma.
I forget what that is again.
Something about boats and shit.
Sounds fun.
How old is this game?
How old, that game is a newer game, I think. It was just made by a dude from Board Game Geek. So this is a game called Love Letter. It's a game I saw Kraken play.
Is it like the game where you have the date phone?
I don't think so.
Oh,
that would
man.
Be awesome. I believe we're supposed to try to win the lady's heart.
Oh, fuck. I'm gonna lose this.
You know, you try your best. Let me see. There's a rule link there. So, aldorak.com/tempest/love letter. Let's see if I get a virus from that. No.
That's what I always worry about.
No viruses this time. Oh, as of May 1st, 2018, ownership of Love Letter and Lovecraft Letter has passed to Asmodee. Oh, okay.
Congratulations, Asmodee. You did it.
You did it, Asmodee.
You acquired them.
Okay. Fair enough. Okay.
Oh, shit, I'm sorry.
So, here's some of the cards. Don't worry about them. We'll figure this out in just a moment, boys. I'm sure. Okay, I know you're unsure right now. That's fine. We'll get there. Almost there.
What are you looking for?
I'm just bringing all the cards so we can see them all.
Oh.
Okay. So I watched a little video. This was like 2 minutes. It was a super short video.
Super short
video. Let me see if I can find it again.
Two princesses makes
How
a princess.
How to play Love Letter in 3 minutes. Let's watch this 2-minute and 43-second video. We can all watch this together. Put it right here. Here, chat. We're all gonna watch this super short video. We'll learn how to play this hot game. Okay. So, let me know when you guys are ready, and then we'll hit this video up.
I'm ready.
All right, Snake and Junt.
1 second. I need to put it on the big screen. Okay, I'm good.
All right, Snake.
Yep.
All right, 3, 2, 1.
Go.
The rules, girl, and this is Love Letter, a game of risk.
Does the rules go single?
I don't know.
In Love Letter, you
I got
play
questions.
A suitor trying to get your love letter into the hands of the princess
okay.
while burning those of your opponents. The goal of the game is to win, and you win by collecting enough tokens of affection. There are 16 cards in the deck, representing the princess and those close to her, each with special abilities that can help you survive and eliminate other players. On your turn, all you have to do is play a card. When your turn begins, you already have one card in your hand and will draw another. Choose one of those cards to play, activating its special ability. For example, playing the guard lets you target another player and announce the name of any other card. If that player has that card, that player is eliminated. Eliminated players put their hand face up in front of them and are out until the next round. When your turn's over, the player to your left takes her turn, and so on, until only one player remains. That player earns a token of affection. If the deck is empty at the end of a player's turn, all remaining players show the one card remaining in their hand. The player with the highest number earns the token. If there's a tie, each tied player adds up the number of their played and discarded cards, with the highest sum breaking the tie. The winner of the last round starts the next one. Keep playing your rounds until one player has earned enough tokens to win the game and the heart of the princess. We already went over the guard, but here's the rest of the cards. The priest lets you privately peek at another player's card. The baron lets you choose another player to secretly compare cards with. If one player has a lower value card, she's eliminated. The handmaid provides immunity from other players' actions until your next turn. The prince lets you target another player. That player discards
Brad
the card
Pitt.
And draws a new
card. Brad Pitt.
The king lets you trade hands with another player. The countess does nothing, but you must play her if you already have the king or prince in your hand. And finally, the princess instantly eliminates you if you play or discard her, so watch out for the prince. Ready to play? Shuffle the cards together and set aside the top card without looking at it. In a two-player game, take three more cards and set them aside, face up. Now deal one card to each player. The player that's most recently been on a date goes first.
Fuck!
A similar game with greater emphasis on bluffing and deception. If you like this video, consider subscribing to the Rules Girl channel.
Can I just say, I like this girl's voice, and I don't know what her accent is, but I like it.
Yeah, it's I don't know, calming. It's charming, yeah. Alright, so you guys get the gist of it then?
I don't understand, the process of... I understand the point of the game, I just don't get the process.
Okay, so from my understanding is at the start, are we all sitting down? We would all have one card.
I thought you burned the top one though.
You do.
Do we burn the first immediately?
Yeah. Okay. Put it face down without looking at it.
You looked at it though.
I didn't look at it. Oh wait, I never flipped it, but that's fine. Okay, so we all take one. Oh yeah, I can look at my card. It's that one. Cool. Neat. Alright, so do we all have one card, Gent?
Oh.
Alright, cool. So...
So for a person who goes first, we'll draw out a card, and then they choose one of the cards in their hand to play.
Yeah, so who was...
Last man standing gets a point.
Who went on a date last?
Scott?
Probably me.
Probably John.
Snake?
Scott.
Alright,
cool. So Scott, you would draw a card, then you would play a card.
And then you do the ability of whatever card you want to pick.
Alright, let me read these one sec.
And the point of the game is to eliminate everyone but yourself.
And you eliminate people based on the...
There are certain cards. Yeah, they just do it.
And how do you, play... Oh, okay.
Right now, you play a card.
Okay. Wait, do I have to play a card?
Believe so.
I don't think so, because it said the countess must be played. That was, her unique thing, remember?
It was, she must be played if you had prince or king in hand. Count to discard if caught with king or prince.
Okay.
You discard the princess, you lose.
Do I want to get rid of cards or I don't want to get rid of cards?
You want to get rid of people.
Yeah, you want to get rid of people. You want to take us out.
Let's see. The Baron compare hands, lower hand is out.
Okay, yeah, okay.
The rounds of this game are a lot shorter than things like Coup.
Okay. Then I'll play this.
Well, now you fucked up! Okay, you can't be targeted then, I guess, right? Okay.
Yep.
And cry, go.
Hey, in 1 second, big bits.
My
marked
friend
all
told
the cards,
me I should donate, so now I have spent $80 on you tonight, so be happy.
Jesus. Your friend's very nice, apparently, but thank you. That's very nice of you. Have a good time with your friend. Shit. Alright, so... Oh. Gotcha. Alright, I'm gonna play the priest... on Snake, I think. Do I get to see that privately?
Tell me about it.
Yeah, that's what they said in the video. Oh, I saw it!
Oh.
Why would you just... Why would you do that?
I'm really rusty.
I'm a dick. In the dark times.
I'm a dick, I'm sorry.
Ganondorf.
This is a test round, it's a test round.
I assume it's my turn.
Yeah. This is a test round.
I'm gonna play the guard and say priest.
That's not my hand.
I'm cry.
Oh, it has to be in your hand.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say. I mean, look at what things do.
I mean, nothing happens if you're wrong.
I'm gonna say Countess.
In Cry's hand?
Do I show it now?
No. If you have the card, if I'm right, you're out. But if I'm wrong, do nothing.
So I could totally lie and you won't know?
I mean, you could, but you'd be a piece of shit.
I'm not a piece of shit.
That's not part of the game mechanics, dude.
I don't have a cat.
It's just metagaming.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I do not have it, though.
I'm gonna play the Baron on Cry.
Oh, me?
Fair hands. He's got the lower value, loses.
There you go.
Wait, do we show it or what?
I don't know. Let's read it. You and another player secretly compare hands.
Oh, okay. Yeah, so, okay, secrets.
I'll let you see mine if you let me see yours.
Okay.
Thanks, man.
Oh, shit. Yeah. You're out, dude.
I'm out, dude. Wait, was I supposed to show this? I don't know.
Yeah.
I was? Okay.
Put on the thing face down.
Oh, face down? Okay.
No, face up, sorry.
Okay.
Right. Scott, your turn.
All right, dude. I'm going to play the Wicked Wango card. I draw a card now, right?
Draw one, pick one.
Does this count as discarding when we put them in front of us?
I think so.
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
He was Zelda Scarlet. Rawr. And
wait, Cry, so you have nothing in your hand?
Yeah, I'm just dead. I'm out.
So you're out.
Yeah.
Okay.
For this round.
And Snake, you got one card. Russ, you got one card. Okay.
Of course.
Hmm.
You can only end with one card.
Jedi streams and lukewarm garbage.
Well, there are cards to make.
Play the guard. I'll target me. Snake.
What's he got, dude?
Do you have a king?
No.
When you stream, do you monitor your voice and your headset? No, I hate that. I have open back headphones.
Well, that's my preferred. Well, that's funny.
And Sieg, thank you as well for 59.
I play the king.
Oh.
Damn it.
You can trade with.
Shit. Who do you want, dude? Who do you want? Who do you want?
Give me your, well. Russ, give me your card.
Well. Yo, Russ, what'd you just get, dude?
Bad news.
Bad news? Oh no, what happened?
Just some bad news. I play the Baron on Snake.
That's pretty good.
You already know what it is.
Oh, that's rude.
Yeah.
So the lower value is total, right?
Total?
Yeah, like the total of all the cards in your hand, right? Oh, wait, you can only have one at a time in your hand.
More or less, yeah.
Yeah.
Unless there's a way you can get more.
Okay.
Because if he would have used that on me, it would have been game over, dude.
My turn?
Yeah.
Wait, what just happened with you and Snake? Why is Snake dead?
Because I Baroned him.
What does Baron do?
The same thing I did to you.
You know the player secretly compare hands? Oh. And then they'll get the lower loses.
You fucking high?
No.
Okay.
I was just confused.
What are you gonna do player? To me? What are you gonna do?
Well, the Countess.
Oh, just discard it?
No, like, if I actually had a prince or a king, would I discard both of those?
No. Just one.
No.
Okay.
Shit, now Rusty might have an idea of what he's got.
It's a maybe. Prince and a king. It was a ruse. It was acting like I didn't have it the whole time.
Wow.
Now this is pretty hot, dude.
A little bit.
Are y'all supposed to give out tokens to see who wins? You give out a token when they actually win.
Win a round?
Yeah.
Handmaiden in your hand.
Is it a handmaiden in your hand, Mr. Jund?
Oh, you're talking to me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it is not.
Oh. All right.
Wait, is it just me and you, Russ?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. All right.
I've been assassinating people over here.
Yeah, he's been like, fucking murdering everybody. You all cold heart.
What happens when you run out of cards?
We can, like, tally something up.
Yeah, you tally whose cards are worth more.
See.
Or it's like, once we run out of the deck, we compare the cards in hand, whoever's the highest win. If they're tied, then we tally it all up.
I think it's cards in hand and on table. I could be wrong.
It's in hand first, and then if that's a tie, then it's a jack go
to set. All right.
That's mine.
Oh.
I did the priest.
Okay.
Your turn.
Gotcha.
I'm starting to see the strats.
Yeah. A prince.
He got him.
This is the last card. Oh, I guess this one was also a... There's the other handmaiden.
Wait, so how many of each card is there? There's four guards and...
You hover over this thing.
Oh, shit, I didn't see this. On that thing.
Strats, man.
Oh.
So I had a 50-50 shot at the end.
Yeah, damn it.
Alright, cool. So all Russ, right, so you get a Russ token.
Russ gets a little
a token of fiction.
There you go, dude.
Cool.
You're gonna get that girl...
Puss, dude.
Get that...
That royal puss, dude.
Yep, you're gonna get that, dude.
That sucks.
You know what?
It's gonna be high maintenance.
Ah, you're probably right.
Yeah, you're right.